Well, hello, DirtFish friends, and welcome to Sardinia. A little later than we'd originally planned at the start of the year, but the important thing is we are here for Rally Sardinia in what might well be the penultimate round of this year's World Rally Championship. Clearly, things are a little bit different this time around. 241 kilometres, it's about 80 kilometres short of what we normally would have. 16 stages over 3 days this weekend. It's going to be no less demanding because, you know, every time we come to Sardinia, it's a challenging event, but nine times out of 10, it's a dry, it's a dusty, it's an abrasive event. Well, it's not going to be quite so dry this time around. There's been a lot of rain here in the last few days, and as you can tell from the countryside, it's really very green indeed. So that will pose, well, a few potential problems for our crews out here this weekend. And what we thought we would do for you is we take a look at one or two of the stages, maybe just to try and highlight what you should be looking for at Rally Sardinia this year. What better place to start than this stage? This is the Tergu stage. Now, your Rally Sardinia goes back round about 16 years, but this stage, well, this has got a long history because would you believe the tyre companies used to come here and test on this stage ahead of the Acropolis rally? That is because this surface is incredibly abrasive. And if you remember back a few years, 2012, I think it was, Sebastian Ogier won this stage in a Super 2000 car because all the World Rally cars had shredded their tyres and he looked after his. But I suppose the big question with this stage is why? Why is it so abrasive? Well, take a look at this. Look, it's a proper road that connects, well, the town of Tergu with the town of Oslo. It's the quickest road. It goes up the valley, it goes down the valley. It's an ancient road. It's a well-constructed, engineered road. And you can see that. Look at these embedded rocks. These have been here for a long time. It's not just been cut out through the hillside. It's been constructed. That means we've got a base. We've got a solid base. There won't be an awful lot of cutting in this stage or cuts appearing because it's such a solid base. And those rocks, well, they're abrasive rocks. But then you've got in places, you've got smaller rocks. And it's almost like, not tarmac, but it's almost like a concrete road in places. They are very, very small, really solidly embedded into the road, sharp rocks. And that is why this stage, short as it may be, is always a tire shredder. I think one of the first things that we can say about this stage, now this was the stage for the P2 test, but one of the first things we can say, come this way, Hickey, look at this, look how green it is. It really is very lush, it's very green. What does that mean? Well, that means it's wet, and it really is. Look at that, damp under there, wow. So we need to be very careful when we watch for cuts this weekend. The cuts could get muddy. Did I say mud? Yes, I did. Take a look at this. Now, it rained a couple of days ago, but all the water comes flowing off the hillsides. What we've got here is an area really typical of the, well, the kind of hill roads that we're going to see during the rally. As the water comes off the hills, it flows off these hills behind us, down onto the road, and it gets saturated. And that is exactly what's happened here. Yes, it hasn't rained for 2 days, but it's still very wet. Couple more days to go before the rally. Will it stay wet? Well, I think it will in certain places. Probably not going to see an awful lot of dust. We might see a bit of mud on the roads, and that could be interesting, in particular for the second pass this week. Well, it's a fascinating rally, this one, isn't it? There are a number of different surface changes, and we've had a look at a few of those, but this is one that's really quite different, isn't it? It's the final stage. It's the Sassari Argentiera stage. Real shorty, this one, around about 7 kilometres in length. And it's become a little bit of a fixture on Rally Italia Sardegna. It really is a beautiful stage. It starts up in the village, way, way at the top of the hill, and it makes its way down towards the coast. Really pretty stage. Just behind us is the sea, and the stage then runs for the last kilometre and a half along the coast. But, well, as you can see, this road, it's kind of been made for the rally. Now, normally when the cars come down here, billowing dust. Really, you can barely see the cars for the dust clouds behind them, sandy dust clouds. But it's quite different again this time of year. You know, We've had a big rainstorm here in the last week or so. You can see that the ground's a lot more, I was going to say, a lot more compacted. It looked compacted, but it's still loose, isn't it? Yeah, it's going to be interesting. There is quite a bit of damage on this road from those rainstorms. Lots of rocks around. Will it be dusty? It probably will be. But here is the interesting thing. We're forecasting some rain. Maybe for Sunday. Listen, that might move forward into Saturday, but Sunday looks like it could be wet. How is that going to affect this surface? Well, we know that sandy surfaces can drain pretty well, but where the water stays, where it gathers, it can get very, very boggy indeed. It's going to be very interesting. The whole rally is going to be interesting because it is so different. It looks so different. Have a look at this, Hakey, the cameraman. Just trying to work out what this is. I think it's rosemary. It's beautiful. Across all the hillsides, we're seeing things this year we don't normally see. Oh, yeah. You know what? They make a lovely drink from that out here. It really is very nice indeed. But folks, don't forget, the place to go for all the updates, all the news on Rally Italia Sardegna is clearly dirtfish.com. Stick with us. It's going to be a fascinating week.